Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Imran Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Ed and Art Mashofsky, Mashofsky Enterprises, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland.
Overcast skies for the ball game, but even though there was some rain, it did not come down that hard and there wasn't much of a wind, so really a pretty good day to play football all in all. The Ducks won the toss of the coin, elected to defer, and the Wildcats inexplicably decided to kick off. That means the Ducks will receive to start both the first and second halves. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for the Ducks. Hargain, Dykes, Hannibal, Cusco, Sunia, and Todd Kunzman coming back from a twisted ankle last week. Musgrave, Bosley, Lavelle, Thomason, and Terry Obey, who will be our halftime feature. Defensively for Arizona, this is a big, physical, fast defense. Smith, Hakes, Johnson up front in the 3-4 alignment. Chris Singleton, Case, Salem, and Alexander are the linebackers. And in the defensive secondary, Lewis, Geyer, Hammerschmidt, the key man there, and Holt at the right corner. Can't remember the last time a team received to start both halves, Coach, but you had that luxury in this contest.
Last year against the Huskies, we kicked off both times, I think.
First play of the game, you go upstairs.
Go upstairs with the old curl and go, good protection. Well executed. But they catch us and knock us out of bounds and we can't go all the way for the touch. But a big 50-yard play. You can see Musgrave give the pump fake here and Obi's running a curl. And then he just turns and goes deep. The Arizona corner bit on it, and Musgrave lays the ball in there, but Arizona speed catches Obi and bumps him out of bounds.
I think a similar play you used against the Huskies a couple of years ago at Autzen Stadium.
Very similar. Now we run a little waggle pass. Musgrave's got a lot of time to throw, a little touch pass out there to Jeff Thomason, starting in tight end in place of Joe Merton.
Go back to the ground. Derek Lavelle knifes his way for a couple, about four, on first down. Or on second down, I should say. That gives the Ducks the first down.
Little hitch pass out in the flat to Terry Obey. Picks up about four.
Second down and six at the Wildcat 13.
Play action fake. Musgrave under pressure, but makes a nice throw to Hargain down to the 1 yard line. And here's a good look at it now as Musgrave comes out. He gets somebody in his face and he just kind of throws the ball around the side of them, and Hargain makes a nice catch. And now we messed this opportunity up pretty good. We thought we could get in with a sweep, and here's Vince Ferry trying to catch the pass, but a good play by the Arizona defender. Singleton, Chris Singleton, pulls it out. Now we run a sweep for a loss. We missed the block by the fullback, and now we're back on the five. So after first and goal on the 1 yard line, we have to settle for a field goal. Not very pleasant.
McCallum knocks it through. The Ducks go 73 yards in 9 plays and lead on the first possession. And then the defense comes in and sets the tone for what would happen all afternoon.
Arizona second back through. We stuff it. Now they come back and try to throw a little screen pass here. And a good job by Dave Cassano, the ex-Folsom High fullback. Didn't quite have the same moves he used to.
He doesn't quite have the same speed, but good hands, good agility to stay in bounds, too. Let's take a look at it.
Well, we're in a normal defense here with Cassano at the nose, and he starts to rush, and he gets blocked here, but he senses, and he has an uncanny ability to read screens and draws. They start flow this way with the quarterback and the fullback, and what they've done a lot of the times is throw a flow screen to the fullback, but this time they set the slot back in protection, slip him out, and Cassano, as he was rushing, felt this lineman leave, and he just followed the lineman out and Veal threw it over there, and Cassano picked it off with one hand, with the fine hands he has. We work on this all the time. Coach Shaffield always throws his defensive lineman interceptions.
Well, if that's what you practice in practice, then you certainly worked it to perfection, but maybe that wasn't the case. Watch Cassano.
They're 43. You can see he feels the screen, man. He gets out there with one hand, picks it off, shakes one tackle, makes a good move here. Good move. Ooh, good move. Look at that. Power.
See, and he covers the ball up, too, so.
Well, he does. He did play fullback at Folsom High School and rushed for over 1,000 yards.
Quite a deal for a guy that's had a couple of knee surgeries, too. So now you have a great opportunity. Dondre Bosley on a play that has worked quite successfully throughout the year. The little trap up the middle. Get you down near the goal line. Bosley again.
Two plays, Sunia and Husko. At the spots doing a good job there. Musgrave flips it out to Kolya Teft, who was unable to practice all week because of the bruised ribs from the onside kick at Stanford, and then he had a wisdom tooth surgically extracted on Tuesday. Nice execution here. Hannibal gets a good block to protect Musgrave, and we throw it for the touch.
So Kolya Teft with his third touchdown reception of the year. He leads the Ducks in that category. The Wildcats fumbled the ensuing kickoff, so they're pinned deep in their own territory again.
There's our big, strong linebacker, Farwell, stuffing the inside play. Look at this play, but again, he's in there again, along with Cassano and Kearns. Fumble, boy, that would have been a big one if we could have got that fumble there, but at least we forced Arizona into a punting situation.
So, I mean, Dick Tomey on the side, I mean, he really got after his troops there. They were down 10-0, and the Ducks in Arizona territory.
Little swing pass to Lavelle, picks up about 5 yards.
This is a 3rd and 4.
Good job finding Bosley over the middle. Pick up, we had our best game in third down conversions in this. We were 8 of 16, which is 50%, which is pretty darn good. You can see Bosley delaying out of the backfield, coming up inside. We hadn't thrown the ball over the middle to our backs very much in the first 3 games. We'd thrown it mostly outside, and I think that caught him a little off guard.
So the Ducks continuing the drive here. This is a 3rd and 8.
3rd and 8. Nice execution to Tony Hargane for the first down again on 3rd and 8.
But the drive then stalls. McCallum comes in, boots through the field goal from 28 yards. And the Ducks lead it 13-0 late in the first quarter.
Quite a start, but it's not going to be this easy. Excellent job there. Cassano coming off from his nose position, clear to the outside. We missed the tackle on the quarterback there by Andre Williams, but he slows him up just enough for Cassano to get Veal for a loss.
2nd down and 11. Try the option again, and this was just perfect defense here. Absolutely nowhere for the offense to go.
That's the way you draw it on the blackboard. Andy Connor's in perfect position. You'll see right here, Andy Connor feathering the quarterback, takes the quarterback. Roy Derry plays off the block and takes the back out for a 6-yard loss.
So it's 3rd and very long. I thought this might be intentional grounding. I thought there were a couple that could have been called that way.
There were. The commissioner in the box kind of agreed with it, but the officials on the field didn't.
There was absolutely no Arizona receiver on that side of the hash mark.
Musgrave over the middle to Jeff Thomason.
Gain of 12. 3rd down and 4.
Nice throw out in the flat again to Thomason for about 8 yards in the first down.
So that is a first down. It also ends the first quarter. 13-0 as we enter the second quarter. The Ducks with the lead. They have the football. They're in Arizona territory trying to score again. But on the first play of the second quarter, disaster as Musgrave's pass is intercepted by Hammerschmidt. And Arizona with a turnover.
It looked more like a field goal attempt. It went end over end. Very bad throw by Bill. And stops a threat and really kind of got Arizona some life back into the contest.
We're going to look at this again, Coach, and I want to get your opinion on what this might have been.
Well, I can tell you exactly what it is. It's intentional grounding that's not called.
Or maybe a fumble. Does he try to pull the ball back? I think he was clutching the thing and it fell out.
But
he's throwing
forward motion. He was trying to re-grab it, but he still had forward motion. Here's a little shovel pass that they've run successfully in earlier games, and Cassano and Labounty do a great job. I just got to mention Labounty. He was up against a 307-pound tackle, and he's somewhere in the neighborhood of 238 or 240. Big turning point in the game. We're dominating and controlling the game, and we fumble an exchange deep in our territory, and Arizona gets it on the 3-yard line.
And it takes them three plays to get into the end zone, but Ronald Veal does on the option. As you mentioned, Coach, I mean, you've got a nice lead. It's 13-0, and you're just totally dominating the football game, and all of a sudden, they're right back in it.
We added some tension and some excitement to this contest. Nice catch by Anthony Jones, a redshirt freshman, for the first down. Anthony, as you remember, caught a few passes in the Iowa game. He's going to be an outstanding receiver. Musgrave on the rollout. Finds Lavelle in the flat. You can see we're still throwing the football. Threw that one a little high, didn't get enough on it, and it was incomplete.
Forces a punt. Mark Penso comes in. And the Arizona man back there let the ball bounce, and it took a good Oregon bounce out at the 16.
Good job by Penso. Excellent play there by Chris Oldham coming up to support the quarterback. You can see we're in position on the fullback inside. Oldham comes up front side, makes a nice tackle, gets help from Peter Brantley from the backside.
I guess it should be noted, when they run the option, it's not always your same defensive man that's responsible for the quarterback.
No, we have some change-ups, and here's a long throw, and it was caught, but it was out of bounds. It was well covered, perfectly thrown, except it was out of bounds.
Yeah, it was just out of bounds, so a good break for the Ducks. They get it back with about 5 minutes to play in the first half, leading 13-7. But the pass is deflected, intercepted by Geyer, and returned down to the Oregon 37.
Big defensive series here. Big defensive series. Veal back to throw, pressured by Andy Connor. Again, nobody there. In my opinion, it's intentional grounding. You can see what they think of my opinion.
Now it's third down, or actually fourth down and two, a little less than two. They try to go with Hampton, the big back up the middle. Nothing there. Ducks take over on downs.
This, I think, is actually fourth and like one, and excellent job by Kearns and Cassano and everybody else on the inside of our defense, and we held them about, as you can see, about a foot short of the first down. Big defensive series.
Indeed it was. And now you got a little spark offensively after the defense did the job, and Dondre Bosley breaks one for 25.
The old trap play up the middle. You can see Hannibal pulling here. Good hole at the point of attack, and Bosley takes advantage of it. Dondre's done a great job in the absence of Latin Berry, and we may have Latin back, so we're going to have a real 1-2 punch at fullback in the near future. Pass out in the flat to Bosley again, picks up about six.
Under 3 minutes to play in the first half.
Nice pass to Reitzig on the sideline for the first down.
So it's first and 10 at the Wildcat 32. We go downstairs for this completion as Musgrave rolls to his left and hits Tony Hargain.
Nice throw here. Hargain battling for extra yards.
This is a third and 7 play. Coming right at you.
Nice job, Terry Obey, making the catch for the first down. And now we're going to make a real bad mistake here. Bill throws off of his heels just before half. The worst we can get there is a field goal. We needed it very badly, and we make another critical error.
And that ended the first half with the Ducks leading 13-7. Ready for the third quarter, the Ducks leading Arizona 13-7. And as we mentioned, the Ducks will get the football again here to start the second half as they did to start the football game. Kickoff was returned out to about the 27. This was a second and 7 play, and Dondre Bosley, again, the leading rusher for the Ducks yesterday, picks up a first down.
Really doing some good things blocking inside. Here's Sunia and Husko again, along with Brian Hannibal, open up a nice hole for Bosley, and we get it out of the shadow of our own end zone and get it out around midfield.
But the drive then kind of stalls this pass. I think it might have been slightly deflected, a little behind Derek Lavelle, but it's a loss of four, and it helped stall the drive, and so The Ducks punt it to Arizona, but the Wildcats can't move it, so the Ducks get it right back.
Run the ace formation and give it to Lavelle on the belly play, pick up four. Musgrave back to throw. Throws complete to Joe Reitzig. Great effort there to get the first down. Just a great effort.
He just did get the first down. It was close.
You can see he's quite short of it right there. Breaks out of two Arizona tacklers, puts his hand down, keeps his balance, and leapfrogs past the first down marker.
So the ball is now out at the Oregon 34.
A little counter play, stuffed up inside. Lavelle makes a nice move outside. Picks up about 3.5 yards.
The next play we see is a third down and two. Sometimes it just pays to be in the right place at the right time. It's such a case for Terry Obey off the hands of Derek Lavelle, and Terry Obey right there for the reception.
The old volleyball tip. Musgrave's got a lot of time here. Probably in this situation should have just pulled the ball down and run it for the first down, but he throws to Lavelle, who's open, has it go right through his hands, and fortunately for us, Obey was there to catch the deflection.
But again, the drive stalls because of a sack here. Musgrave never had a chance.
Busted line protection call there, and we just turned somebody loose on him, and he had absolutely no chance.
So, with about 4 minutes to play in the third quarter, there has been no score, just a defensive struggle for both teams here in the third quarter. Hampton gets just a couple.
Good job by LeBounty on that play. Now Veal goes back to throw. Good pressure here. Oh, my goodness, we missed the tackle. Veal scrambles out, but Dale Reed comes up and makes a nice tackle short of the first down.
They threw a flag for a face mask, but they said it was after the play. I didn't understand that.
Yeah, well, the explanation I got is just the play was dead, and it was an inadvertent face mask, which is no penalty after a dead ball. So, I mean, I don't know. There were a lot of things that I didn't understand. I wasn't going to argue with that one.
Second and nine plays. The Cats get it back. And now they mount a bit of a drive. This is really about the only sustained thing or semi-sustained drive they had all day.
Completion there between Derry and Oldham. Now they run the option pitch outside, and one of the few breakdowns we had, we didn't get somebody up on the pitch man, and they pick up a nice gain.
We're into the final 15 minutes, and we've got a lot of exciting action yet to come because this ball game is still on the line. A lot of people's stomachs still churning at this point in the ball game. Ducks leading at 13-7. Wildcats, as I mentioned, driving, but this was a third and 12. And so they forced the field goal. Barely through.
Just barely through.
You got to get one of your tall guys, get a basketball player from Don Munson, and get him up there batting those things away.
Yep, 7-footer. Here we run the trap play up the middle. And Lavelle picks up a good gain of 11 yards. You see the trap up the middle, and he gets a nice hole and picks up 11 yards, and now he has to leave the game because something happened to his chin strap, and wouldn't you know it, there's another nice hole on the next play to the tailback.
Calamani.
Nice cut by Nalu, and he broke it back to the left side. You know, the interesting thing is in the recruitment process, he made his final decision between the University of Arizona and the University of Oregon, so I'm sure this was a big run for him. Nice blocking on the backside there, and he turned on his speed. Arizona had a little bit of an angle on him here, but a nice 45-yard gain.
Ooh, look out on the sidelines. Sideline camera person, Carrie Brooks, getting out of the way at the last minute.
Well, she's taken a few blows in her life. Nice catch here by Hargame, but, ooh, disaster, disaster. Fumbles the ball right into the hands of an Arizona defender.
So the Wildcats dodge the bullet as the Ducks looking for a put-away score. And the defense again comes in and does the job.
Look at the green jerseys out there. Now that we've done a good job pretty much eliminating the inside running game, I'm amazed at how many people. Mark Kearns does a good job playing off the block, coming outside, getting in on the tackle. Chris Oldham up there. Marcus Woods also. Derek Horton just getting a lot of green shirts around the ball now.
You know what's amazing, Coach, is that the fact that you only used, what, 13 players on defense, so they were still fresh at the end of the ballgame, had speed, had their legs in there.
They weren't on the field a lot, though.
Yeah, that does make a difference.
Not very many snaps, unlike a week ago. Ooh, good job there by Cassano, getting the sack. Matt LeBounty forced him up into the pocket. LeBounty gets knocked by Veal, and off comes Cassano, and he holds on for the sack.
He had quite a game defensively for the Ducks. He had 14 tackles and two tackles behind the line of scrimmage, not to mention the interception.
Good job here by Terry Obey. Almost breaks this one. Good hard running and gives us excellent field position now.
About 8.5 minutes to play in the football game. Ducks leading by only 3 now.
Good job by Musgrave as he got hit just as he released that ball. We pick up a key first down, good protection, except he got pressured a little bit. And this is the one that they didn't allow us to jump at the ball. They said it was uncatchable. They threw a flag, but they ruled it was uncatchable. I don't know, and here comes McCallum into the wind with a nice 42-yard field goal.
Yeah, you mentioned the wind because it was really no factor until about the fourth quarter. It kicked up a little bit.
And then we try to squib one, but we don't get it past their up man, and we end up giving them great field position here as Eric Castle makes the tackle.
The Wildcats have the football out around midfield. In fact, now they've got it in Oregon territory on a 3rd and 4.
We get cut on the perimeter there and lose contain. Good job by Rory Derry coming up and making the tackle.
Come back with a draw.
Draw play, well played. This has been a big play for him, but LeBounty and Farwell are there to stop it for about a 2-yard gain. Veal back to throw again. Gets pressured here. Good job by LeBounty. And it's incomplete.
Now it's 3rd down and 10. Incomplete.
Incomplete again. Good pressure by Andy Connor, starting the first game of his career. Now we're backed up deep, hand off to Lavelle, and he gains about 1.5 yards.
Arizona really strapped as far as the timeouts were concerned in this situation, too.
Trap play up the middle, gains about 3.
The clock continues to wind all during this time because Arizona only has one timeout and they'd like to save it for offense.
Just short of the first down here, about probably 0.5 yards short.
Did you consider taking a safety at that situation?
We thought about it, but the way we were kicking off and everything, we just didn't think it was to our advantage to do that. We punted the ball out of there, hadn't had much trouble protecting, and excellent job here stopping the fullback, Williams, LeBounty, and Farwell. See again, great job. I want to tell you what, Matt LeBounty, you see what he did to that 307-pound tackle? He stuffed him up in the air and then made the tackle. I'm tickled to death with him. LeBounty's got great technique and quickness and pad level. He gave away over 60 pounds to the man that was trying to block him.
Real confusion here for Arizona. They called a timeout on 3rd and 2 and got totally confused as to their substitutions and took a 5-yard delay of the game penalty.
Obviously a critical penalty, and I want to commend our crowd. I think they contributed to Arizona's confusion. The noise, it was great, and a big play here by Andre Williams coming in the backside. Veal tried to pump, but obviously there was coverage downfield. You can see him looking here, but we've got his man covered. He pulls it up, and bingo, Andre Williams is right there to make the sack. Hey, look at Farwell. He's being tackled by the offensive lineman, but they're not going to call holding at that stage of the game.
Now it's 4th and 12, and again, Arizona had confusion according to the post-game interviews, and they ran the option into the short side of the field.
Well, you can see he was trying to get outside, but Andy Connor was right there, and he had no place to go, so he tried to duck it up inside, and that's the ball game.
Yes, indeed it was the ball game, as the Ducks, with their favorite play, the quarterback gets it and just goes down on the knee.
We'll kill the clock.
Yep. And that is the ball game, as a jubilant crowd and the team celebrates a very important victory, the final 16-10. Let's take a look at some of the statistics team-wise, and we'll talk about the individuals as you look at the team. Look at that, only 7 first downs for Arizona. Yards rushing, well, the Ducks had good balance. They had 3 right around the 50-yard mark, Bosley with 60, Lavelle 50, Kelemeny with 48. Passing, Bill Musgrave was 24 of 40 for 240 yards, one touchdown, three interceptions. And the total yards, what a job by the defense. And the offense, of course, 364, pretty good outing too. Flip over the page, the one black statistic in the game for the Ducks, turnovers. But it's a credit that you turn the ball over five times and yet still come away with a victory. And third down conversions, as the coach alluded to, 50%, and that helped the Ducks to a time of possession advantage of 31 and a half minutes to 28 and a half for Arizona. After the game, we went into the locker room and asked some of the players about the game.
We wanted to get better this week, and I think we did. We just played with a lot of emotion, and you know, it was in the back of our mind, that Stanford game, I think. It was personally in the back of my mind, so we just wanted to go out there and, you know, play for 60 minutes, not 54. I read screen at the beginning of it, and after that, I really couldn't tell you much. I just remember the ball bouncing around. I think God just set that in my hand, because I don't really remember, honestly, too much of that play.
Basically, we were just assigned to different areas, and everybody had to concentrate on the area, and if everybody did what they did or supposed to do, then definitely we shut down the defense.
Talk about the importance of next game against Washington State.
It's very important, you know. We got to win it. We're give it all we got, you know. After a win like this, I think we're going to do really well. Came really strong, ready to go.
Our team was so fired up when we first got out there that, you know, we knew we could do it. We felt confident. You know, in the second quarter, I don't think we were as confident. They got the momentum back and made things hard for us.
Defensively, we had to, you know, we had to just bear down, you know, and do a lot better because the offense was, you know, really clicking that way. They were doing pretty good, you know, getting the ball down the field, but they were just punching in for the score. So our defense just had to toughen up, you know, and that's what we did.
Obviously, you know, we had a little problems, but, you know, we overcame that. You know, we played a little sporadically. We had a few big plays, but we made a couple mistakes. So, but the defense did keep us in the game, and I'm glad they played it as well.
Your team is in a situation now that you were in 2 weeks ago. You came off a big, big win. You had defeated Iowa, then you went down to Stanford and emotionally had some problems in that ballgame. Now you come off another big emotional win. Even though you're at home, I know you want to maintain that emotional intensity and that high.
Well, it's obviously important. You can't play in this league unless emotionally you're ready every week. We proved that in the Bay Area 2 weeks ago. I think we're probably more emotional for this game against Arizona than we had been in any other contest this year. Certainly we're going to have to be ready not only this week, but the week after and the week after, because we're playing good football teams in this league, and when you're not ready, you're going to struggle.
All right, it should be a good game out at Autzen Stadium. We'll see you next week out there, if not, right here on the Coach's Show.
Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Immer and Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Ed and Art Mashofsky, Mashofsky Enterprises, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland.